Now let us discuss about arrays. Now the students who are coming from C programming background or C++ programming background, the arrays behave very different in Java as compared to C language. I'll show you what is the difference. Actually, the main difference here is that arrays are implemented as classes, and here we create an object of that particular class. But in case of C and C++, whenever you are declaring an array, now for that array there is some kind of memory allocation is done, but there are no inbuilt functions or no predefined functions that is available for that memory location. What do I mean to say by this is, see, look at this case. Let us say I am declaring an array in C language and I am declaring an array in Java. So it can be C++ or C, or it can be Java. Okay. Now in case of C and C++, if I am doing integer A with 5 index, or make it 3 index location, what does that mean? It means that there is an array, the contiguous memory locations are done. So if the address of first memory location is 1000, so the next location will be 1002, the next location will be 1004, so on like this. Okay, and this A is just storing the base address of this one. So this is how the arrays are implemented in C language. So there no inbuilt functions are available. But in case of Java, arrays are implemented in the form of a class. Okay, so what I do is, here in Java, if I say integer A is equal to new int with 3 index locations. So here you can see, when I just do integer A, that means I'm just declaring that A is an object of type integer array, and it is going to store a reference of an integer array. Okay, and here I'm allocating some memory, I'm creating an object. This is an object creation. This is an object creation. So that means I'm allocating some memory, I'm allocating some object, and I'm putting the reference of that object in A. So if you represent it graphically, so what does it mean? That this is A. Now this A is pointing to some object. Now in this object, we are having the memories, which is 3 index locations 0, 1, and 2. A part of this, there are some functions that are already available. For example, there is a length function. For example, there may be different kinds of functions that are, you can say, methods. See, in Java programming language, we call them as a method rather than calling them as functions. Okay, so there may be different kinds of methods that are already available, that are already defined. So here, every array, whether it is a single dimensional array, whether it is a multi-dimensional array, whatever the kind of array is, it may be an integer array, it may be a character array, it may be a float array, or any kind of array. Now these arrays, for these arrays, this is just storing the reference. This is just storing the reference, and this is some object creation. So this is the object, right? So for this object, some memory is created, some memory is allocated, and in this object, there will be different kinds of functions or as well as the constructors that may be available. And we use those methods or constructors to perform different kinds of functions on the array. Okay, so let us just read a theory about it. So an array is a container object. As you can see, it is a container object. Okay, so whenever you study in array in C language or C++, they say that array is the collection of contiguous memory allocation where you store homogeneous data type, or you can say data of same type. But in case of Java, an array is a container object that holds a fixed number of values of a single type, a fixed number of values of a single type. Okay, second, the length of an array is established when the array is created. That means once you have created the length of an array, you cannot change the length. Okay, and after creation, its length is fixed, and each item in an array is called an element, and each element is accessed by its numerical index, which are numbering between, where the numbering begins from 0. For example, here, as you can see, there are 3 and value. So for every value, the numbering begins from 0. The first numbering will be 0, but the last numbering will be 2. Therefore, if the array is having a total of n items, so the numbering will be 0, 2, n minus 1. Right? An advantage is that readability of the code is improved, as well as it will be easier to manage the memory location. So how will you declare an array? So to declaration, you can do integer brackets space A. Okay? So this is actually recommended representation. In Java, there are different ways of declare an array. right? So, but in C language or C++, there is only one single way. That is, you have to write these brackets after the variable name or recursive after the array name. So, here you can declare an array like this, or you can declare an array like this, or you can declare an array like this. That means you can have any number of spaces here, you can have any number of spaces here, as well as you can have integer A, you can have any number of spaces here, and then you can have like this, right? Because I think you already know, if you have studied the compiler design, then you know that preprocessor is going to remove all these extra white spaces. And when you declare an array here in C language, you declare the size here, okay? Because whatever the size you are going to declare, that is that much amount of memory is allocated. But here, when I declare an array like this, the size is not given, because for the size we are going to create an object. So this is wrong. Even if you do something like this, this is also wrong. So let me just show it to you with an example here. So here I'm using integer brackets ax. It means I'm declaring that ax is an array. So this is just a declaration. Okay. If I do ax is equal to new int 10, that means this is an assignment, and here I'm creating an object of type integer. And this object will be having some memory location. It means that ax is there. Now this ax, because of this line, it is going to point to some kind of object, and this object will be having total of 10 memory locations like this. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on till 9. And in these locations, I am going to store some values. For example, ax of 0 is equal to 5. So 5 will be stored here, ax of 1 is equal to 6. 1 will be 6 will be stored here, ax of 2 is equal to 7, 7 will be stored here, ax of 3 is equal to single inverted commas a. That means the equivalent value, integer value, that is 97, will be stored here. In the same way, for every index location, I am going to have some values. Now here I am doing integer b is equal to ax. Now you can clearly see here, b I am declaring an array. So that means b will be there, and b will also point to the same object. Okay, so I'm not saying the memory location, mind it, I'm not saying the memory location, I'm saying the same object. Because this object will be having so many different member functions as well as constructors. Now when I'm saying character ch is equal to like this, so this is also a way of declaring an array as well as initializing it to some memory location. So here again, c is going to point to some memory locations, and here we are going to store a, b, and c. Actually this is c is going to point to some object. And in that object, there will be memory locations, which is going to have this thing. And there will be some member methods or member functions. Now, if I say integer c is equal to ch, this is completely wrong. Why? Because this is an integer, and here it is a character object, character array object, I should say. So this is an array kind, and this is of integer type. So this cannot be done. If I try to do integer d brackets is equal to 1, 2, 3, that means I have created d here, which is point to some memory location, or which is referring to some memory location which is having some data element. But if I say d is equal to dx, remember here the size is that here we are having only 3 elements, but here for ax we are having total of 10 elements. So if I do d is equal to ax, that means d will now be referring to this location. Okay, so d can refer to any of the memory locations, d can refer to this location, as well as d can refer to this location. So whenever you are declaring an array like this, it can be just, for example, int d, or it can be int ax. So declaring an integer array like this, so it does not specify, it does not mean that you cannot refer to a memory location of different size. For example, here you can see d was initially referring to a memory location of different size, and ax was referring to a different size locations. I mean, ax is referring to an object which is having memory location of different size, dx was referring to an object which is having a memory location of different size. So this size of these memory locations does not matter, but these are, you can say ax and dx, both of them are declaring, both of them are array of same type, that is integer type. Therefore, it can point to that, or it can refer to that. Actually, it can refer to that, or ax can also refer to that. So we can change the references like this. Okay. So there is just a small introduction regarding the arrays. Now let us look at how can you declare multi-dimensional arrays here. Because the way the memory is allocated to a multi-dimensional array in Java, that is a lot different than the memory is allocated to multi-dimensional arrays in C and C++. Because in C and C++, we generally use the row major order of creating a multi-dimensional array. But in case of Java, we create multi-dimensional array by using single-dimensional array only. Okay? So in Java, it is quite different as compared to whatever done in C language. Okay?